Hi, and welcome to today's video. We are going to go over winding bobbins. I am going to be using a Jillian Dye Beginner's Guide to Bobbin Lace by Jillian Dye and Adrian Thunder. It's a really good book for anyone interested in learning, not that pricey either. And it's going to be, I'm going to go through the patterns on it. And you can kind of see on the back some of the things that you can make with it, which is pretty cool. So the first kind of pattern we're going to make is on page 22, the cloth stitch bookworm. I'm going to keep the book kind of off camera because of copyright, but if you buy the book and follow along, you'll know what I'm talking about. And if not, if you have just any kind of book, it should be laid out in quite a similar way as this one, where you have a pattern, you have directions, and kind of supplies needed. So then let's go to our pillow. I know I said we're going to go to our pillow, but I just wanted to kind of show you how I like measuring the thread. I have a quilting cut mat that you can kind of see is pretty long, and this has your inches marked on it. This one goes up to 24 inches, and I like using it for measuring the lengths of the thread. And so looking at the pattern, they mentioned two different colors, dark and a medium blue, and this is my medium blue that I have, so we're gonna go with it. On page 22 of the book, they tell you how to prick the pillow, prepare pricking, and which we did in the previous video. We pricked a pattern, not necessarily their pattern, but a different one, and pricking is all the same. And this one we are going to have, we're going to need 7 pairs of bobbins, and we are going to put one pair of bobbins, we're going to put on 72 inches. So this is 24, so I'm going to measure out to 72 inches of the dark. Again, this is how I like it because I'm a little OCD, so I really need this to kind of know that my measurements are correct. You can also just measure across your body and do it that way. It is also certainly fine. I know it's kind of hard to see my thread on this because it's blue on blue, so I'm sorry about that. But when we do that, and so that is the 72 one, and I also like doing a little bit more just for it, and then kind of giving me a little leeway on it. And then we take our scissors and we cut it out. And then I'm going to move this stuff out of the way. And then we are going to re-go with our pillow. Let me just move the camera. I will eventually have this working fine so it's not so much movement. But so we have our pairs of bobbins and we have our thread. So because we measured a long piece, we want to get to the middle. So we're going to just kind of go, and I have one end here and I'm just finding the other end. So here I have both ends in my left hand, and then we're going to use our right hand to kind of follow up and get us the center. So this here is our center, which means that we will have approximately even bits on both bobbins, which is what we want. All right, and then what we're going to do is we're going to take the top bit and we're going to fold it over itself so we kind of have this two circles. Taking your corsage pin, one with a glass needle, you're going to put it under one and then under the second one. So under one hole, under the second hole, we are going to pin it into our pillow and then we're going to tighten. And that way it kind of tightens our string. And as you see, as I pull, it's not pulling, the thread one way or the other. That's how you know it's tight. And then we're going to have the end of one string. It doesn't really matter which side you go with. I'm currently on the left-hand side. And we are going to do one circle here. And then I kind of tighten it, and then you're going to bring this, hold it up, and then bring it around its side. So you're picking up and rotating so that we have two E's, two circles, however you want to do it, call them. We're going to put this first one, the one closest to the end, over the second one. So putting this over there so they're overlapping like that. And then we're going to take our bobbin that we want to thread, and we're going to put it in between the two of them, and then we're just going to tighten. And as you can see, we tightened it, but there's like this little bit of straggler out here. So we're just going to wind this. So I'm pulling taut with this and then rotating down with my right hand. So it's rotating the bobbin, but the thread is shortening. And we don't want to get super, super small. So like something like that is pretty good that I feel comfortable with. And then what we want to do is we want to bring this taut, which I know is difficult because it's a nice long piece. So let me change cameras. All right, so we've changed cameras and I'm holding this guy taut. Move you out of the way. And then I'm just going to roll it down the thread. So I'm rolling it away from me and just kind of keeping it to the front of the bobbin and just kind of keeping the thread nice and taut on it. And we are just going to wind this down. And then I'm going to switch back to my other camera when we get there, because I'm keeping it taut and now you're going to be able to see it better with the other camera. All right, so we switch cameras and it's still taut, and I'm rolling it towards myself. You can see I'm keeping it kind of towards the front bit of the bobbin, and that's just going to help keep control over the thread a bit more. And then when we have like a couple inches left, this is kind of where I do the hitch. So with the hitch, you put your finger over it, wrap it like you were in the same direction that you were winding it, put it over, and then go over, and there you go. There's your hitch. And I will show you again. I'll try to get closer on the other side of the bobbin. So we'll do that. Making an E here. E here. And putting it through. And making it so there's not as much, tightening the thread so it's taut, and then winding it through. And eventually I'm going to come up to the front of it. go. Let's bring you closer so you can see a little bit better. So here I was winding it up this way, and now I'm flipping it over just so the thread is on the top. It just makes it easier for me to wind it. You put a finger on top of it, and then you're going to wrap it around the finger and then the bobbin like that. So you wrapped it around your finger once and then around the bobbin again, and then we are going to bring that up and over and then tighten, and you have a hitch. And then we take this out and these are connected. And then a nice thing to do with your bobbins after you threaded them is hold it up by one and just let it untwist. This takes the twist out of the thread, so your bobbin and lace are nice and straight, and you're not going to have any issues when bobbin lacing. And that is how you wind a bobbin.